Hi students, I am Professor Aves Ahmed Husseini, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yadrao. In last video, we discussed the points related with that boiler mountings. In this video, we will discuss boiler draught in lecture number 6. So let us start with the what is exactly that boiler draught. Generally, students, we know that in case of the steam power plant, the most important component is boiler. So whatever the combustion process is carried out in that boiler, the output of that combustion process and the outcome of that combustion process is that flue gases. And these flue gases are exhausted to the atmosphere through the chimney. But before that, they are utilized in so many components like that economizer, air preheater and superheater. So this is boiler draught. So the main, there are two basic functions of that boiler draught. The first is thrown away the that burned gases to the atmosphere. That is the main reason of that boiler draught. And the second is the draught is necessary to force the air which is available in, and it is mandatory in case of the combustion chamber for the proper combustion process. So there are basically two functions of that boiler draught. So boiler draught are classified into two types. The first is natural draught and second one is artificial draught. Again, that artificial draught are two types. The first is that mechanical draught. The second one is that steam jet draught. The mechanical draught again classify into two types. The first is induced draught and second one is that forced draught. Again, the that particular steam jet draught is again classified into two types. The first is natural steam jet draught and second one is that forced steam jet draught. So let us start with the first type, that is natural. You can say it as a chimney draught. In this case, the amount of draught is directly depends on the height of the chimney. It is produced due to difference in density between the column of the hot gases in the chimney and the similar column of the cold air outside the chimney. So here you will get idea in that particular figure. So this is the boiler furnace. The grate is there. Grate is nothing but the area in which the combustion of that fuel takes place, and whatever the flue gases are produced, these gases are continuously moving through the area of the chimney and finally it get exhausted to the atmosphere. So there is no any kind of the pump of then any kind of the blower and fan are used to move for moving and for circulation. So because of that basic physics, like that, because of that density difference, the air is continuously moving and it's thrown away to the atmosphere through the chimney area. So there is no any kind of the special arrangement is required. So it is, the name is given that natural or that chimney draught. The second important draught mostly used in large capacity power plant is that artificial draught, where the generation capacity of the steam is very, very large amount. So there are again two types. The first is that forced draught and second one is that that induced draught. The basic difference between that forced and induced is, in case of the forced draught, blower is used before furnace, and in case of the induced draught, that particular blower is replaced and placed here before chimney application. So here you will get the idea of the forced draught. In case of the forced draught, there is a one boiler furnace. In great area, the combustion of the fuel takes place and a tremendous amount of the flue gases are produced. So what exactly that blower do? The main function of that particular blower is to forcefully creating the motion of that flue gases, and in this way, that moving that flue gases are moving in forward direction and it passes over the economizer, air superheater as well as air preheater, and finally is moves out to the atmosphere through the chimney. So this is all about that forced draught. The next is induced draught. In case of that induced draught, that particular blower is placed just before the chimney. So here you will get idea about the induced draught. In induced draught, the main function of the furnace and that particular grate is to produce the combustible gases after at the end of the combustion process. So whatever the flue gases are produced, these are passed through the n number of the accessories like superheater, economizer, air preheater, etc. and at the end of this particular section of the air preheater, the pressure of that and the velocity of that flue gases becomes poor. So in order to increase their velocity, the blower is used. Here that main function of the blower is to continuously blowing that air in at a high velocity, and finally that that flue gases are thrown away atmosphere through the chimney area. So this is all about induced draught. So students, the main difference between that forced and induced is, in case of the forced draught, that particular blower is placed in the furnace area, and that blower continuously blowing the air, and in this way the air is that particular gas or that flue gases are continuously moving in forward direction. But in case of the induced draught, the blower is placed just before the chimney, and whatever the flue gases are coming up to that air preheater level, they are poor in that velocity, and finally its velocity goes on increases with the help of that blower, and finally it moves out to the atmosphere through the chimney. So the third important is the combination of that forced as well as that induced draught. So here it is a combination, so the name is given itself, the balanced draught. If we use that forced draught and that induced draught in alone way, then there is a lot of the problems regarding that maintenance point of view. So it is always preferable to use the combination of the induced draught and forced draught instead of the forced or induced draught alone. If the forced draught alone is used, then the furnace cannot be open for firing or for inspection purpose, because the high pressure air or sometimes that flue gases inside the furnace will try to blow out, and there is every chance of the blowing out of the fire completely and the furnace may stop. So if induced draught fan alone is used, then also furnace cannot be opened either for firing or for inspection. So this is a major issue. So to overcome both these difficulties, balanced draught is good option. So in case of the balanced draught, forced draught, like that blower is placed before that application of the furnace, as well as that ID, that is induced draught, like another blower is placed just before the chimney. So in both way the circulation is done, and this is the efficiency of that balanced draught is good as compared with that forced as well as that induced draught. So the next important is that steam jet draught. So it is a very easy technique. So in case of the boiler, we produce a steam, and that particular steam is utilized in the combustion chamber for the moving of the flue gases in the area of the chimney. So the construction of the system is very simple and easy to maintain. Thus the maintenance cost is also less in case of that steam jet draught. In steam jet draught system, a small portion of the generated steam exhaust through a nozzle, and the kinetic energy of that particular jet of the steam, of the high velocity steam, drag the air or the flue gases in the boiler system. We can categorize the steam jet draught into two types. The first is natural steam jet draught, and second one is that forced steam jet draught. So the first is that forced steam jet draught. So in case of the forced steam jet draught, we feed a portion of the steam produced in the boiler to the entry point of the furnace through the diffusion pipe. Due to that, the kinetic energy of the steam, there will be a draught at the entry point, because of which the fresh air get dragged to the grate and then to the economizer, then to preheater, then ultimately it leaves out from the chimney. So here the utilization of that diffusion pipe is most important. So the name is given that forced steam jet draught. The next is that natural steam jet draught. In natural steam jet draught, we fit the steam nozzle in the smoke box attached to the bottom portion of the stack. The stack is nothing but that draught. The steam forcefully enters in the smoke box, due to which the flue gases created in the furnace get dragged in the smoke box because of the resultant draught created the kinetic energy of the steam jet. This process of creating draught in this way is called as a natural steam draught. So students, this is all about the boiler draught. In this video, we discussed the so many things related with the boiler draught, their classification like natural draught, then artificial draught. In that artificial draught, we discussed the two types, that is forced draught, then induced draught. Again, another combination of both, that is combined draught. So the next important is that steam jet draught. Again, in that steam jet draught, there are two types. The first is that natural steam jet draught, and second one is a forced steam jet draught. So thank you for patience listening.